Hi! If you're returning, welcome back. If this is your first time, welcome. I'm so happy to have you guys back on my channel today. We're going to be exploring 7 things we collectively need to stop doing before 2021 ends. Come along with me. Let's explore these. People pleasing. Number one on my list is people pleasing, because this is something that I particularly hate in myself, and it's something that I also hate when I spot, a trait that I dislike when I spot in other people. You no longer matter. They do. Over you, in your decisions, your goals, your dreams, your circles. You have to stop people pleasing. I need to stop people pleasing as well. It's a disease that quite a number of us suffer from. We were either taught, or we just learned from seeing the ones we love do it, or engage in the bad habit that is people pleasing. It has to go. It's not serving us. It never did. We've all been people pleasers at some point in our lives. I think it definitely comes with the territory of being human. We want to please, and we tend to want to please other people outside of ourselves. If we were to trace this habit back, I bet that for most of us, things would trace back to our childhoods. Culture, conditionings, how we were raised in our individual homes, certain religious responsibilities. So things will definitely trace back for most of us to our childhoods as it pertains to people pleasing, because that's where it started for most of us. For instance, I don't know if this remotely happened to any of you growing up, regardless of where you grew up, but when growing up, I noticed that in the small town I grew up, certain people were a little more bold than they should have been in their interactions. For example, sometimes guests would show up to our home unannounced, ring the doorbell, and be like,
"Tell your mommy we are here to see her."
Sometimes it would be one person, other times it would be a clique of 2 or more people. Unbeknownst to my mother, they wouldn't call, text, or nothing. I would go to her room. Mind you, this scenario occurred countless times as I was growing up. "Mommy, so-and-so is here to see you." Often my mom would go check up on the guests. "Okay, let me go greet them," she would say. Even though she's evidently irritated, irked, and quite frankly, she has every right to be angry if someone just shows up to your house unannounced. Obviously, it was people from church, workers from a project or something. It was just annoying how they would sometimes show up unannounced and find 0 issues with their behavior. "Hi, good afternoon," and sometimes she would engage in conversation, give them food and drinks or whatever. And other times, she's like, "No, I don't want to see any guests right now. They didn't even tell me they were coming, you know? And I'm tired." I'm like, "Mom, do you want to go tell them yourself that you're tired?" And she's like, "No, that would be rude. People pleasing." And she didn't want to have an awkward encounter. She would just say, "Tell them I'm sleeping." And whenever she would tell me, "Go tell them I'm sleeping," I used to get so excited to get these guests out of the house. I happily would go down, notify the guests, "My mommy said to tell you that she is sleeping." Some of them would get the message and would be like, "Okay,
we would return another day."
And some of them that had zero shame would be like, "Okay, we'll wait till she wakes up," you know? How do you make someone uncomfortable in their own home?
"We'd wait till she wakes up. Can you bring us food and drinks?"
One dude, he was like, "Can you go to the kitchen and ask if they're serving the same fish and rice that they served me last time I was here?"
"No, don't you have rice and fish in your house?"
It's the entitlement of it all for me. People pleasing occurs in many ways, like choosing a career path and being miserable to make your parents happy. forgetting that sometimes when you drift so far away from God's ordained path for your life, then you're merely existing at that point. Not standing firm on your beliefs and values to please your friends. Buying designer or new Apple products you really can't afford to please other broke people. Or investing in expensive goods and items, not because you want them, but because you want to be seen as being part of a certain social class in society. It's all very lame. I can bet that there are people out there that have sold vital organs just so they could buy like a new iPhone or something. People really do the most. It's worse when you fall in love with a people pleaser. Because people pleasers don't please themselves. They make the active decision every day to please everyone but themselves. So how can they please you? Some of us may have to go to therapy to break these people-pleasing chains. Essentially, is you always standing at the back of the queue and letting everyone else go in front of you constantly? How are you going to get to your order, get to your wants and your needs? My heart genuinely goes out to all the people pleasers out there. I mean the ones that are actively pleasing everyone outside of themselves. You deserve better, and I hope that you resolve whatever internal issues make you do this thing, which is serving everyone but yourself. Two. This one also needs to go. This is one way many of us consciously or unconsciously delay our life's assignments. It's true. For some of you, God put it in your heart to write a book 10 years ago. You didn't do it. You're just waiting. And I'm not sure what you're waiting for. Perhaps pens to fall from the sky, or a MacBook Pro to fall from the sky. Divine, miraculous display of God's mighty work. Some of you, it's an idea He gave you for an app 7 years ago, but you played with that idea, and now He has presented that to someone else who took charge of that, executed, and now you're living vicariously through their lives on social media or something. Or you've seen the person on the news talking about an app idea that is so similar to the one you had, but you've never crossed paths with this person. It's because you played with the idea. God gets it, and He wants to bless you with another. But you're even procrastinating on praying. So He's finding it hard to communicate with you because your ears are plugged into everything the world has to offer. Procrastination is arrogant for many reasons. It is. It's arrogant to assume that any of us will be here tomorrow. More so, next year. We can only pray, be disciplined, hope for the best, work hard. All I'm saying is, do that thing today. It starts with the small tasks. You see a mess in an area of your home, perhaps a section in your living room. What do? Do you attend to that mess immediately you see it, or you wait till 2 weeks later? Don't start your day outside of your house without making your bed and tidying up your house. Write that script today because the world needs to see it on television. Register for that internship. Cut off that toxic person. Don't wait till 2023 when you think they might change. You have to cut them off now. Many people lost their lives in 2020, not living their lives full expression, simply because they made an error, which we all do. They thought they had time, more time at least. The only time we have for what's important is the time that we have now. Don't pretend like nothing is happening when someone emotionally assaults you, for instance. Even if you are not a confrontational person. Basically, don't be patient with people that disrespect you. And as we all know, disrespect can be hidden under the disguise of a joke. I'm sure we've all been there. Not everyone is as direct with their insults or direct in general. If it hurts you, say it. If someone has now made you feel invalidated as a human being, say it, especially in the given moment. You don't have to consider how they'd feel about you being assertive when they didn't consider your feelings or emotions when they were emotionally or verbally assaulting you. Being assertive allows you to express your genuine emotions and respond accurately without being condescending. If people do attempt to take your power from you, you should always take it right back. And being assertive to someone who's being disrespectful to you is one way that you can do that. I always make reference to my mom because she gives me the best advice. My mom told me this less than 3 weeks ago. Deal with people how they think they're dealing with you. Oversharing will get you in some serious trouble. And oversharing to the wrong person could literally be you digging a hole for your own grave. We all need to operate on a need-to-know basis. Meaning, before passing on information to anyone outside of ourselves, we need to ask ourselves a few questions. Does this person need to know this detail or information about me? What's the worst that can happen if they know this information? How can me sharing this info be detrimental to me or others? It might sound obvious, but not everyone needs to know everything about you. In fact, not everyone needs to know anything about you. One time oversharing got me in trouble was also one of my biggest life lessons. I was friends with this Nigerian guy. We met when I was still living in the UK. We met at university. We became friends quickly. We had the same interests, were both Nigerian, similar goals and artistic dreams. So we meshed very well as friends. He and I were friends for like over 5 years. I felt like I knew him and I trusted him to a certain degree. In our relationship, often we'd share unreleased ideas, dreams of giving back to Nigeria. I'd send him scripts I'd written for his feedback, or sometimes he would send me storyboards he had made for a music video. Anyways, one time we were on FaceTime and I shared an unreleased documentary idea with him. I'm like, thinking of doing this documentary in the next 2 years. I want to go back home to Nigeria and shoot. I think it's a good topic and I think it has the ability to garner a lot of attention. The FaceTime call ends. 2 weeks later, my friend calls me on FaceTime. He pitches back the documentary idea I had about Nigeria back to me and spends over 20 minutes trying to convince me that he had come up with this idea. After a while, I'm just like, you know what? This conversation is over. Bye. I go on Twitter. This guy has gone on to tweet, "Very soon, I will fly with a team from the UK to Nigeria to establish and shoot this documentary." Then he mentions the subject matter of the documentary. That was when I was like, wow. So you steal my idea, try to pitch it back to me, then you go on Twitter talking about this idea. In case in the future I make legal troubles, then he can show the tweets like, "Look, this was my idea, blah, blah, blah." To me, that was diabolic. That was probably the last time I ever spoke to that guy. Him being that type of individual, you don't announce to people like that you're cutting them off. You just withdraw, and at some point it would catch up to them that you're no longer in their lives, because that's what he deserved. He didn't deserve any conversation of, "Hey, you stole my idea, so I'm cutting you off. What's the point?" He knew what he was doing. It's so important to compartmentalize a friend and associates. There are those friends that shouldn't know anything more than, for instance, in my case, anything more than the information my IMDb profile says about me. That's all they need to know. Obvious details. Not everyone should know important details about your life. Where you live, unreleased ideas, your next move, your dreams, your goals, family disagreements, financial records, great artistic or innovative ideas. Who you're dating, they don't need to know. Before the year 2021 ends, we all need to stop oversharing. You can do it. Just ensure that you keep a lot of yourself to yourself. What are idols? Anything or anyone that comes before God in your life, that you prioritize over God in your life, is now your idol. That is now your God. For some of you, shopping and clothes are your idol. That's your God. For some, it's people pleasing. You're essentially a slave to pleasing people. And your idol is people's acceptance of you. Some of us Her idols are streaming platforms and entertainment services in general. In a sense, anything we give access to our unique power and strength is our God. This manifests in different ways. Some people create something, then they give that thing their extraordinary power. The thing starts to breathe and it becomes their God. It translates in other ways. For instance, there are many people that probably don't remember the last time they gave God thanks for their lives and unique blessings that they're enjoying, but they have time for gossip. Some of you, your family has become your God, and whatever ideas you're trying to pursue with that, for instance, an idea of perfection. Celebrities are gods to many of us as well, unfortunately. And for some of you, the universe is your God. God made the universe. Imagine creating something and people often giving your creation all the due respect and credit that you deserve. Stop giving things and people your power. Anything or anyone can become your idol when you make them number one over the very one that should matter. If you have bitterness, hatred, malice, unresolved traumas, jealousy, envy, there are a lot of negative emotions that weigh us down. I just mentioned a few. You have to let it go because we can't soar with these things weighing us down. You must be light to fly. Remember that. Even when we travel, think about the process of how they check your bags. You have to follow a specific limit. Otherwise, you have to pay for the extra you'll be bringing on the plane, right? I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm excited for my next level. And I'm also aware that not everyone can come along with me. Not everything can come along with me. I'm most excited because I know that my future, my entire future is in God's hands, which is the safest place I can ever be. So for now, it's all about detoxifying physically and spiritually.